Hi, I'm Dr. David Goodman-Meza, and I'm a doctor who specializes in addiction medicine. I'm here to talk about fentanyl. Here's what happens during a fentanyl overdose and how you should respond. The signs to recognize of an overdose are the person will lose consciousness and will not be woken up by talking, yelling, or rubbing their chest. Next, you may notice that their breath slows down and becomes very shallow. Each breath can become more than 10 seconds apart and progressively longer until they stop breathing altogether. With this, their fingers and lips may turn blue or ashy. What should you do if you recognize if someone is overdosing? First off, call 911. Most states in the US have Good Samaritan laws, which mean that you may be protected from prosecution even if you have drugs with you for personal use. These laws differ by state, so it is a good idea to check the specific laws in your state at websites such as the Safe Project. If you have naloxone on hand, administer it now. If they are having shallow breaths, you can provide a rescue breath. If they are not breathing, check for a pulse, and if they don't have a pulse, start CPR and chest compressions. If they don't wake up after 2 minutes, administer a second dose of naloxone. Stay with the person until medical help arrives. Despite what the news will tell you, you cannot overdose on fentanyl just by touching it. Truth is that fentanyl we find on the street, either in pill or powder form, cannot be absorbed through the skin to cause an overdose. This is misinformation that has been debunked by leading organizations such as the American College of Medical Toxicology. Some people use the fact that fentanyl patches are used to deliver fentanyl to cancer patients as proof that exposure to fentanyl through the skin is possible. And that is completely true. However, these patches are specifically designed for this purpose and are only able to deliver small amounts of fentanyl over 72 hours. Our first responders, police officers, firefighters, and EMTs are so important in saving lives. This myth just causes unnecessary panic and fear in our first responders, but the reality is that you cannot overdose from touching fentanyl. If an overdose occurs after consuming fentanyl another way, call 911, administer naloxone, do rescue breathing, start CPR and chest compressions if needed. But the reality again is that you just cannot overdose by touching fentanyl. If you're someone who uses drugs, how can you reduce the risk of a fentanyl overdose? Here are a few tips to help you or someone you know stay safe. Fentanyl is an opioid. The same overdose prevention strategies apply to other opioids. Never use drugs alone. If you're using alone, it is best to be prepared. Let someone you know check up on you or use a remote spotter through an app like Brave or a phone service like Never Use Alone. If you live in a place like New York that has an overdose prevention center, consider using there. Test your drugs with fentanyl test strips or get your drugs tested at a testing site if you have one near you. The amount of fentanyl in a dose is somewhat unpredictable even if you got it from the same dealer or it's from the same batch. Get your drugs tested to make sure you know what you're using. Sites and laws vary by location, so check what is available to you wherever you live. Make sure you and your friends have naloxone on hand. Don't mix drugs. Always start low and go slow. If you're looking to stop using fentanyl or other drugs, treatments like methadone or buprenorphine and other treatments can help. People are understandably scared about fentanyl. Watching the news, you see more calls for criminalization or punishment. But as a doctor who specializes in addiction, our focus should be on expanding treatment and making options more accessible. Methadone or buprenorphine are medications that are highly effective treatments. By taking one of these, you cut your risk of dying of an overdose in half. If you're not ready to stop using drugs, make sure to use as safely as possible. Harm reduction programs can help people access safer injecting and smoking equipment, naloxone, fentanyl test strips, and other supports like testing for infectious diseases and referrals for treatment. Lastly, overdose prevention centers are facilities where people can be monitored while using drugs. They connect people with addiction services and social support, including housing services. How do we address public fentanyl use? Public drug use has more to do with a lack of people's ability to access housing and affordability than with increases in the number of people using drugs. Housing prices have escalated and options have dwindled. Unfortunately, most cities just do not have enough housing options for the amount of people experiencing homelessness or at risk for homelessness. We lack a true safety net for people who are about to become homeless and a system that makes it really hard for someone who is homeless to get housing. We need more housing and especially affordable housing. But for the housing units we have available, cities need to invest in housing-first models for people who use drugs. These models prioritize getting people into housing despite their use of substances. Once housing is secured, a multidisciplinary team of support workers and medical professionals can address their substance use disorder and mental health issues. Treatments such as methadone and buprenorphine work, but we know that people who are experiencing homelessness struggle more with relapse than people who have housing. Thus, making it easier for people experiencing homelessness to get housing while in treatment is essential for their success. Another solution are overdose prevention centers. These are sites where people can use drugs in a monitored setting. These sites connect people with addiction services and social supports. There are over 100 of these sites worldwide, and where they have been placed, evidence suggests that public use of drugs, littering of drug paraphernalia, and crime goes down. Lastly, investing in community-based crisis response teams that prioritize peer health and social worker outreach to engage people in treatment services is key. Thanks for watching. Now you've got the facts. Share this video to spread accurate, science-based information about fentanyl. It's time we dispel myths and promote public health. Visit drugpolicy.org to learn more.